My name's Henry Lukas. I'm the Education Director at the Spellman Museum of Stamps and Postal History, located on the campus of Regis College in Weston. And for the next few minutes, I'm going to share with you some postage stamps that have been issued to celebrate famous historic events and birthdays of famous people. At the museum, we like to connect history and stamps. In fact, when you visit the museum, you don't have to be a stamp collector to enjoy our displays. They're historical, they're artistic, they're scientific. Stamps cover all sorts of subjects, and that's what we're going to be doing in the next few minutes. So this is October, which is a special month for stamp collectors, since this is National Stamp Collecting Month. Something special we do at the museum, we invite our museum members to bring in parts of their collection on display. So hopefully you can visit us this month and see all the different types of stamps, envelopes, and other philatelic objects that people like to collect related to stamps. Also this month is National Hispanic Heritage Month, and we have a special booklet available this month. It features famous Hispanic Americans who are on American postage stamps, and we hope that there are some Spanish teachers out there come by for a free booklet, because not only is it written in English, but it's also written in Spanish. So let's look at some of the special events that are celebrated in October. October is National Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and there is a special stamp that the Post Office issued a number of years ago that has raised over $50 million for breast cancer research. And what you do is you buy the stamp for the postal rate and then pay a little extra fee that's given to the collection for the research work. Also, everybody in New England goes out and picks apples in October, and this is National Apple Month. So get out there and pick those apples. If you like coffee, you can have a special celebration on October 1st, because October 1st is International Coffee Day. October 6th is National Poetry Day, and it's also Mad Hatter Day. If you remember the Mad Hatter from Alice in Wonderland, people over in Colorado started this day to celebrate the Mad Hatter. Why did they pick October 6th? Well, if you look closely at the Mad Hatter's hat in the ribbon up top, it says 10-6, which was the price of the hat, and hence October 6th is National Mad Hatter Day. If you like to smile, and we hope you all do, the next day you can smile all day long, because October 7th is World Smile Day, and I think you'll recognize the smile on this stamp. And then I'm sure we have many people out there who have their cats at home. Well, reserve October 29th for National Cat Day. And I have a special stamp to show you. It's actually the first stamp that featured a cat, and it was a stamp to honor Lindbergh, who almost took his cat with him on his flight to Paris back in 1927, except he thought that the cat might add a little too much weight to the plane, so he had to leave her home. But the Spanish people issued the stamp with the cat. Let's look also for October for some of the famous birthdays this month. The first birthday was on October 2nd in 1869. Mahatma Gandhi was born in India. And of course, we all know all the wonderful how he helped bring independence to India. Interestingly, a lot of people think he won the Nobel Peace Prize for all his work, but he was never awarded that. So his birthday is on October 2nd. Way back in the year 1181, the famous Saint Francis of Assisi was born in Italy. And also on that day, one of our president's birthdays, born in Delaware, Ohio, President Hayes was born in 1822. His wife was named Lucy. She got the nickname Lemonade Lucy because Rutherford B. Hayes was a Methodist, and Methodists did not drink. So when there were ceremonies at the White House, Lemonade Lucy served lemonade. Another famous birthday on the same day, October 4th, is an artist called Frederick Remington, who went traveling all around the West doing famous paintings and sculptures of cowboys and Indians. October 5th, we could say, is the birthday for the modern Bulgaria. It declared its independence in 1908 from the Ottoman Empire. Another president born on October 5th was President Chester Arthur. He was born up in Vermont. And if you remember back when Senator McCain was running for presidential office, some people thought he might not qualify since he was born in Panama. Well, they did a little research, and some people think Chester Arthur was actually born in Canada since his town was right on the border between the United States and Canada. Another birthday, right here in Massachusetts, a very famous Robert Goddard was born in 1882, and he did many experiments with rockets, and in 1926, he shot off the first liquid fuel rocket. And if you go out to Worcester and go to the high school, the team out there are called the Rockets. Thor Heyerdahl, a name that some of you may be familiar with, was born in 1914. He believed that travel could be done across the oceans and built a ship called the Kon-Tiki to prove that the oceans could have been crossed way before Columbus. A famous airline pilot from World War I, Eddie Rickenbach, was born in 1890. Received a lot of recognition for his winning of the dogfights in World War I. Later on, he went into auto racing and became the head of Eastern Airlines for a number of years. The very famous John Lennon of the Beatles celebrates his birthday is on October 9th. He was born in 1940. We also have a birthday for the United States Naval Academy, which opened on October 10th. In 1845, with 50 midshipmen. If you like opera, you can celebrate Giuseppe Verdi's birthday on born in 1813. His Rigoletto, La Traviata, and Aida of some of his most famous operas. On October 11th, Eleanor Roosevelt, the wife of Franklin D. Roosevelt, was born in 1884, and she was obviously very important as a first lady. And after Franklin Roosevelt died, very important in getting the United Nations organized. Back in 1644 in London, a gentleman named William Penn was born. He was a Quaker, and he and many of his followers came over to America and settled the state or the colony of Pennsylvania. And if you translate Pennsylvania from the Latin, it means Penn's Woods. One of the that was in 1644. Another president's birthday in October is President Eisenhower, who was born in 1890. There's a little connection with President Eisenhower and Cardinal Spellman, the founder of our museum. Cardinal Spellman was the vicar of all the Catholic chaplains in World War II, is when he got to meet President Eisenhower. And when Eisenhower became president, he gave a number of his stamps to the cardinal to include in the museum. Another birthday, a name you might remember, Lee Iacocca, the famous car designer, was born on October 15th in Pennsylvania, famous for leading the Chrysler Company, but we also have to thank him for the design of the Mustang. October 16th is National Dictionary Day, and the reason that was picked was because Noah Webster was born on that day back in 1758, and he was the first American to really create a standardized dictionary for the English language in America. Another famous birthday on October 16th is the Irish playwright Oscar Wilde, who was born in 1854. And another playwright born on the same day is Eugene O'Neill, who was born in 1888, famous for his plays and also for receiving the Nobel Prize for Literature. A name in British history, very important, was Christopher Wren, born way back in 1632. And he designed the famous St. Paul's Cathedral, which survived the Blitz of London. And he also designed 52 other churches in London. The famous composer, Franz Liszt, was born in 1811, probably most well known for the Hungarian Rhapsody. And the famous artist, Picasso, was born in Spain in 1881, and his artwork has appeared on a number of stamps, as you can see on the screen. And we have another president born in October, and that's Teddy Roosevelt, born on October 27th in 1858. And a birthday for a university was Harvard University, or at the time Harvard College, was founded on October 28th. The image you see on that stamp is supposed to be John Harvard, but it turns out no portraits were ever done of John Harvard. And so when the sculpture was done, he asked one of his friends to sit And that's how, what we think John Harvard looked like. And we can also have kind of a birthday for the Statue of Liberty, because in 1886, the Statue of Liberty was dedicated in New York Harbor. October 28th, birthday of a very important doctor, Dr. Jonas Salk, who came along with the polio vaccine, which was a very important discovery and got rid of that horrible disease of polio. He was born October 28th, 1914. And one more president's birthday. October seems to be president's birthday month. John Adams, our second president, born in 1735. And if you'll notice, he's on a 2-cent stamp because he was our second president. So those are some of the birthdays for October. Let's take a quick look at just some other events that have happened. Why don't we go in reverse order? On October 31st, Mount Rushmore, with its images of four presidents, was completed in 1941. And sadly, on that day in 1948, Mahatma Gandhi was assassinated in India. Some other events in October, the Model T went on sale in 1908, Henry Ford building a car that he hoped everybody could afford, and it came in any color you wanted as long as it was black. And then just a few more events in October. October 2nd, an important day in the history of the Supreme Court, Thurgood Marshall was sworn in as the first African-American justice on the Supreme Court. That was in 1967. And 10 years earlier, on October 4th, the Russians launched the Sputnik, the first satellite to go around the Earth, which really sparked a lot of interest here in our country. So those are the events for the month of October. We hope you found them interesting, and we hope this encourages you to visit our museum. Don't forget, if you mention that you've seen this show, you receive a discount on our admission. And hopefully you have some questions about stamps, so we'd like to get mail. So please get that postage stamp out and send us a letter. Again, thank you for watching.
I started crew when I was 14 years old. I grew up in the Midwest. I came back east to prep school and started crew at Exeter. I was a coxswain. I went out for the sport because I was a little guy. I weighed 80 pounds when I was a 14-year-old and became a coxswain. And I was a coxswain in the eight-oared crew in 1956. There were, in my crew, six of us out of nine had gone to prep schools, and five of those six had rowed. So we had had previous experience, but there were four of the people in the boat that had never rowed. One guy had never rowed a year before he won a gold medal in the Olympics. In fact, two of them had never rowed before. So now that's almost impossible. The colleges, the rowing colleges don't even accept walk-ons anymore. You know, people that go to college and expect to take up rowing that have never rowed before. A lot of the people, well, the colleges recruit. Let's face it, they, you know, most sports recruit, college sports now recruit. They go after not just Americans that have had rowing experience, but you know, they go all over the world looking for talent.